Okay, what are the best apocalyptic and post-apocalyptic TV shows that I've seen? Hey guys, welcome back to the DemCAD channel. This is something I'm very much into. You guys know that I'm into emergency preparation, but I also like to watch TV shows and movies where there's a big crisis and civilization's crumbling and people are sort of forced to act. People are forced to work in groups that they normally wouldn't work in. And I love that dynamic about these type of shows. And I love how characters are tested, how their real character is revealed by the crisis. Because I believe that crisis reveals character, not necessarily builds character. It just reveals who you really are. But anyway, some shows that come to mind, of course, you have Jericho. Okay, this is a show that takes place in the American heartland, in the Midwest. There's a nuclear explosion near this small town. It's actually in the big city. This small town is pretty much cut off from the rest of the world, and that's where the series begins. Now, the series focuses on just regular people. The family dynamics is a huge part of the show. And I love how the show sort of moves from there. And even when it starts to explore, like, for example, one of these characters is a CIA agent or somebody who's working with deep within the government and has a lot of knowledge about what's going on. And they learn more about the big crisis. Even as that happens, the show is always very much focused on relationships and very much focused on family. If you haven't seen that show, at least look at the first couple episodes, first couple seasons, I recommend. Because I love how it gets into government conspiracy and all this other stuff. And also community relations. What happens when you have a limited amount of food and some people have access to the food and other people in town, they don't have access to the food. How do you deal with the trade and barter? How do you deal with outside groups? Pretty awesome show, Jericho. Highly recommend it. Another show that really comes to mind, and it's probably not a show that you think of as far as apocalyptic, is Battlestar Galactica. Now, Battlestar Galactica is a good show to look at if you want to look at the politics of basically an apocalyptic event where aliens, well, not really aliens, they're not aliens. They're not living beings in the same sense that we interpret. Well, the whole show really digs into that, the philosophy and all that stuff, which is pretty awesome. You can call them robots or whatever. They basically, the Cylons, they basically attack the human race, and pretty much all of the humans are wiped out except for a small group of ships. And look at the political dynamics and looking at how the human race tries to survive this event, even though they had traitors, even within the human race, is just really fascinating. Anyway, a show you may have not heard of, that's definitely worth looking at, is a British show called Survivors. Look for the 2008 version. The show was on the air for 2 years, 2008 to 2010. It's called Survivors. This show is actually about some type of plague, virus wipes people out, wipes out most, pretty much all of humanity. Now may not be the best time to watch it, given current events, but hey, you know, it's a fantastic show because I love how it shows us how regular people, even one guy who escapes from jail, from prison, how they have to deal with interacting with other people, how they have to make certain choices, life or death choices. And the first season is just definitely really interesting. I like how the groups form and how they gotta decide who to trust, who not to trust. It's called Survivors, it's a British show, really awesome. Another show I like to watch is not like the other shows, but it's a CW show of all shows, of all networks. It's called The 100. Okay, I love this show. I think it's been on for, what, 7 or 8 years or so? I think they're on season 6 or so. This is an awesome show. Usually I'm not into CW shows, but it's much darker than what you will normally get from the CW. I love that. So essentially, the human race is wiped. The planet is pretty much destroyed by nuclear apocalypse, right? Some survivors end up on a spaceship. They bring these spaceships together and they actually form a massive station called the Ark, where this is where all the humans are. Well, at least that's what we presume at the beginning of the series, that this is all that's left. They don't know if the planet below Earth is inhabitable. They're pretty much assuming that it's uninhabitable. Nobody can live down there. It's been 100 years since this massive event, and they decided they have a big crisis on this Ark. The oxygen system can't provide enough oxygen. The life support system can't provide enough life support system for everybody who's on that ship, because over the years, the population's increased, and they actually floated people. By floating, I mean they put them out into outer space where they would die, of course, instantly. Put them into a capsule and then they just floated the person. Well, they actually decided to get 100 kids Yes, 100 teenagers who were convicted of various crimes. They send them down to Earth, and they give them these little trackers, these little bracelets to see if they're able to survive on the planet, because they don't know if, hey, we can survive on the planet. And that's where the series begins, with these teenagers. And, you know, it's a CW. One thing I like about the CW, well, at least they cast good-looking women. I will say that. I mean, that's one thing I do like about the show. It's a lot of cool characters. Octavia is my favorite one on there. You see certain females become leaders. Clark, the blonde, she becomes a leader. And throughout the whole series, they all, male and females, they have to make some pretty dire decisions. They are stuck with some horrible choices, and it definitely makes me wonder, okay, what would I do in that situation? Because it's not as simple as, oh, this person's bad, this person's good, because you have people who do terrible things who end up becoming heroes later on. And you know, people who are heroes in the beginning who make some pretty questionable decisions moving forward. And, well, I don't want to spoil it too much, but definitely worth checking out. So these are some shows that come to mind. There's a show called The Rain, which I enjoyed. It's actually in another language, but it's very, very watchable. These two kids, they get their parents lock them up in a bunker, and they're able to survive this catastrophic event where most of humanity is wiped out. They believe it's environmental. Maybe it's the rain. When they finally come out of that shelter, these two kids, brothers and sister, they spend a few years locked up together in that bunker. They come out and they explore the world. So the first season is pretty good. At the end, the last episode, I sort of wonder, like, what the heck are you doing here? But anyway, I think it's worth checking out. Other shows, Revolution, that was a pretty interesting show. It just wasn't realistic enough to be something I could really recommend. Some of these shows, you got to suspend, you know, common sense, or you just got to look at it as like a fantasy world, something like that. Because with Revolution, you know, people shouldn't survive the things that they survived, but it's basically a situation where the grid is wiped out, the electricity is pretty much removed from society, and we watch things crumble. So these are some of the shows I would definitely take a look at. What other shows can I comment on? The Last Ship. I've seen the first season of that. That was interesting, but for me, it just felt like one long Navy advertising, one big commercial for the Navy or something. I don't know. Which is nothing wrong with a commercial for the Navy. It was just, you don't need to see hour after hour after hour. Basically, there's an outbreak, some type of viral situation there, and those Navy ships are one of the few things are not really touched by this virus, and there's a big search for the cure and all this other stuff. So it's interesting for maybe one season, but definitely ones I would check out. The 100, Battlestar Galactica, you guys have probably already seen that, but definitely Survivors and Jericho, really good. And if you're looking for something also involving some type of virus or whatever, something called Jeremiah, which aired on Showtime, it was a viral situation where most of the adults were wiped out. The only people left were kids under a certain age, I think 12 or so. They're the only ones left who survived. And I thought that was a pretty interesting show, at least for the first couple seasons. So if you guys can recommend a really good post-apocalyptic, or even better, an apocalyptic series, even if it's foreign, or say if it's something made in a different country other than the U.S., whatever. If you can find something like that, let me know. Put it in the comment section below. So there you guys go. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.